Hey guys, this is Danny and welcome back to another video. And in today's video, I'll be going over some of the fastest methods to gain XP in Treasure Wars. There have been, as you probably know, some updates to levels, and one of them was Treasure Wars getting to 100 levels of XP. So I wanted to give some tips and just some ways that it can help you get higher levels and get XP quicker. So yeah, let's head right into today's video. But first, I just want to say, make sure to like the video. You know, I always forget to like videos, so sometimes reminders do help. So make sure to like it because it really does help out a ton. And also make sure to subscribe if you are new. It really does help out a ton. And you know, it's free. And so many more high videos and streams and stuff will be happening that you will probably enjoy. So yeah, let's head right into today's video. So the first option of today's video has to do with Treasure Wars solos. So basically, I was just thinking about this the other day. If you take a party of 8 people, get yourself and 8 friends, or find people who would cooperate. I know not this is impossible for everyone, but for most people, they could probably find a way to get a party of 8 people together, even if they're not friends, just other random people. And basically, play Treasure Wars. But so on a regular game of Treasure Wars, obviously there is a rule about no teaming, and they do not want people to team in a game because you can get banned for that. So basically what you can do is get a party of 8 people and just rush each other. Do not protect each other's treasures, just rush each other, and the first person to win wins. So just, you don't have to, there is no rule against not protecting the treasure. So what you can do, you get in there and just everyone don't protect and just rush each other instantly, and then a bunch of people will get XP for rushing. And yeah, you can't like let someone get your treasure because that's against the rules of teaming in theory, but what you can do is just rush each other and yeah, and just make the games go by really quickly, get the final kills, don't run away too much, just kind of take your death in stride rather than doing that. Just get a bunch of people to cooperate and the games will go by super quickly and you will get a ton of XP that way. So basically, the fastest ways to get XP in Treasure Wars has to do with breaking treasures or has to do with final kills. And you can technically get XP from like farming kills if you just keep spawn killing someone. However, it doesn't give as much XP as breaking a treasure does. So if you do a method where you just quickly end the games, that will be able to get you the most XP. So the second best option to get XP in Treasure Wars has to do with either squads or mega mode. If you are able to get a squad together or a mega squad together of like 8 friends or just a big group of people, and you guys are able to just rush through mega and get the treasures and just break theirs quickly and kill everyone off quickly, then you will be able to get a ton of XP quickly because you get XP for every treasure you break and for winning games, obviously. So that is a really good way to just quickly get through there and get XP rather than having games that take long or playing solo and having to get into intense battles with other good players. This is just a good way where you can get a squad of good players and just quickly go in there and get a bunch of XP. The worst way to try and get XP on the Hive, like I said, on Treasure Wars, is if you spend way too much time in a specific game. There are some people who want to get to level 100 really quick, people who will try and want to be one of the first people to get there. There are already people who have finished, like, if you don't know, the picture from the thumbnail is actually one of my staff who did end up already getting level 100. Just from, you know, quickly going through games. He actually played a lot of solo because he's really good at the game and just went in there and just quickly won all the games. Pretty simple like that. But there are a lot of people that aren't as good, or recreational players like most of the people probably watching this video, who will just be trying to find quicker ways to do it. And the way that's the quickest way is to not take too much time. If you are in a game, even if you don't care too much about your wins, like your win, how many games you win, how many games you lose, if you get into a game where you've quickly broken a bunch of the treasures, let's say you're playing squads, and then you get into an annoying group where they're just sitting at, they're building a fortress, they're bow spamming, they're just not letting you get across, you honestly can just like let them end the game or just leave the game and get new XP, because it's not worth just waiting there and trying to fight people that are just going to take a long time to kill when you can just go to a new game and requeue and quickly go get some more. So yeah, it is up to you in that sense. If you didn't want to do that, I probably would. If it was me grinding, I don't really care about my wins to losses, but some people do. Leaderboards players may care about that. So yeah, that is totally up to you if you wanted to do that. Another great option is duos. If you do happen to get a good teammate, if you do not have a good teammate or someone that you're talking to, it'll probably be harder. But if you're communicating with someone and you are both good at the game, you could probably both go in there and kill off other teams pretty easily. Just, you guys can just go separate ways, get good stuff, and do that. That is, you know, totally up to you if that works. I would still say that the best option would be the first one I said, and then Mega, because that one you can quickly end games if you have a really good team. Quicker than duos, for sure. But yeah, that is another option. If you do have a good teammate that you are playing with, or just two people that are really good at the game, that could just 2v1 teams and get them out. And now that we've gone over all of the ways to get XP, I want to go over some of the ways that will help you go about doing it. Just a few tips in Treasure Wars itself. So the first thing is to be very aggressive. If you are going for XP, you want to be aggressive. You do not want to let other people steal your kills or treasures because you want that XP yourself. If you are playing a regular game, you want to be a little more conservative. But if you are just specifically going to get a bunch of XP, then you want to be very aggressive and you want to make sure that no one else will steal your treasures. Another tip is when going for XP, you do not want to waste your time going for emeralds. If you do get emeralds, you should use them on ender pearls and snowballs. Snowballs to knock off other players when chasing you or across a bridge, and ender pearls to quickly teleport over players to break treasures. In theory, if you don't really want to go for emeralds and treasure wars. I know they're tempting because they give you diamond armor and that's what you'd want. The only game that would be smart to do is if it's a really close game and you know you think you need it because the other players are really good and you want to have that advantage. But honestly, if you're going for XP, most of the time in Treasure Wars, you want to get emeralds. When you get emeralds, you want to get snowballs and ender pearls first, and then diamond armor is something that should come second rather than getting it right away. And honestly, I think that's everything that I have for today's video. Treasure Wars XP isn't really that hard to get if you know what you're doing, and hopefully this video helps you know what you are doing. If you would like to see tips on how to win Treasure Wars, I did make a video a while back on my tips to win Treasure Wars. Keep in mind, it was on Xbox One edition, so it is old, it's a while ago, but all the tips still do apply today, and a lot of people have been able to get help from that video. It has over 30,000 views. So yeah, if you do want to check it out, I will have that at the end screen if you are interested in getting some more tips on Treasure Wars in general. And yeah, also, make sure to subscribe. Like I said, if you want to see more content on The Hive, more giveaways, tips videos, news videos, anything that you'd really want to see on The Hive, I will try to do it and make a bunch more content on here for you guys to watch. So I definitely recommend doing that. And the other video on the end screen will be my most recent video, which is talking about the bridging glitches and method and just the brokenness of it from the last update. So if you want to check out that one as well, feel free to do that. So yeah, that is going to be all for me. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. And yeah, I hope to see you in the next one. Have a great rest of your day and goodbye. Also, don't forget to like. Thank you. Bye.